time is 8:14, and we are making meals this morning. Joining us once again is Executive Chef Justin Johnson from Harvest Market. Good morning.
Good morning.
Now, last time I said it smelled good, I didn't sell it well enough because this smells even better. What are we making now?
Well, how about a little respite from the cold and we take a trip to Morocco?
Let's do that. Let's go.
Okay.
We love it.
So it's a Chermoula marinated mahi, and we're going to do kind of like a Moroccan ragout, we call it, which is the word we chefs use when we don't have another word for it. It just basically means a bowl full of stuff.
All right, let's get to it.
All right, so I have a pan here that is getting warm, and I'm just going to put in a little bit of oil, and we're going to sear our Chermoula marinated mahi.
Ooh.
In there. And the Chermoula is just oil, cilantro, mm-hmm. Some cumin, paprika, a little bit of cayenne, some garlic, and then it's just pureed into like a smooth paste, and then it's just marinated in the fish.
Okay, well, smells good, so.
So once again, we're just going to, look out.
Whoa.
You're in a splash zone.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is keep this a one-pot meal, just like our last one. So the fish is going to be going in this pan, and we're just going to throw the carrots right in there. Very mm-hmm. common ingredient in Moroccan cooking. The reason we put the carrots in first is because they're going to take longer to cook than everything else. So we want to like get those started and start to get them a little bit tender. The mm-hmm. other thing you'll notice is that I sliced them very thin to sort of help the cooking process a little bit as well. And then we're going to put in some slices of garlic.
Okay.
And if you're doing this at home, you're going to have more than 3 or 4 minutes, so I'd probably let that go for a little while. But for our purposes, we're just going to get going with everything else. I'm going to throw in some red onions here.
Okay.
Some tomatoes, which, you know, this time of year, it's hard to get good tomatoes, obviously. So if you can find a good heirloom tomato, greenhouse tomato, or if you can't find any of that, just like some cherry tomatoes or grape tomatoes is going to be your best bet to really get that flavor. Then we're going to go in with some green peppers. And you see all those colors kind of jumping off?
Ew, looks colorful.
And then we're going to throw in a little bit of fresh cilantro, some sliced olives. And that's going to give it kind of that salty, briny kind of quality that's going to sort of bring it around, pair really nicely with the spiciness and the sweetness of the marinade and the fish.
It smells good, so.
And then we'll throw in just a little bit of salt. We don't need to add too much because we're trying to keep people's health in mind.
Right.
As always. And then we're going to deglaze this pan with a little bit of lemon juice.
Well, now this smells really good.
Yeah, now you're going to turn that over. You can see we got some nice color on our mahi. And we're just going to let the steam and all the moisture and the flavors just kind of permeate that fish and cook it the rest of the way through before we go ahead and throw it in our bowl.
Well, that looks absolutely delicious, very colorful and healthy, all vegetables. Well, Chef Justin, thank you so much for joining us this morning and cooking these wonderful meals. Everything smells delicious.
My pleasure.
We certainly do appreciate it. And if you would like to see this recipe so you can make it yourself, just head to the food page of WISN.com, and that is where you can find this recipe and the one from before with the cauliflower salad, all very delicious. Thanks once again.